In this video, we're going to talk about 5 easy tips to help you survive and get through an IT cybersecurity audit. This is going to be particular to DoD, government contracting, military, because the DoD has a fetish for auditing, right? You're going to be audited various times from different agencies, different regulations. It's just there's this thing with cybersecurity on the military side where they just love to audit. You'll have redundant audits, redundant checks, different organizations, or what have you. So if you haven't been a part of these meetings or processes yet in your career, it is inevitable. It's going to happen. I myself have been on both sides. I've been an auditor and an auditee. And although it can seem nerve-wracking, let's say you have one coming up and you're just looking up some information or you want to understand better, these 5 tips will help you survive and get you through it. These don't come in any order. Okay, so it's not step 1, step 2, step 3. They're all equally important. I would focus on the ones maybe that you may be weak on or don't have a good grasp of or not even heard of. So this first one is probably the most obvious, right? It is to know your stuff. Know your environment. Know your documentation. Know what's going on. If you yourself are a person of interest in the audit, know your stuff, right? Brush up on the environment. Brush up on the regulations. Whatever you have to brush up on. Make sure you know it in and out. One of the main things that I've seen in bad audits is the person that's being asked questions or being audited not being knowledgeable in what they're being asked about. And this could be because they maybe not have experience there. They're not there long enough. There was no one else. Whatever the reason, right? It's just, in my experience, is generally unacceptable to have somebody speaking on something they can't articulately. So yes, don't have somebody who doesn't know about the particular thing being audited speak for that item, right? And if this is you, know your stuff, right? This should be a no-brainer for anyone out there that has to participate in an audit, whether you're an auditor or an auditee. Right. If you cannot speak on a particular technology or a particular thing if you don't have the knowledge of it. Right. So that's number one. Know your stuff. And generally, you're given time for these audits. Right. I mean, there are instances of surprise audits. Unfortunately, that's just the nature of the beast as well. But for the most part, they are scheduled out. So you have some time to study, to brush up on certain things, to understand your environment. Again, this first step is really simple. This one is just know your stuff. If you know your stuff, you'll be more comfortable. You can answer questions. And then the other part of that is if you are asked something that you don't know, but it's your, and you can't defer to somebody, right? The response, I don't know, is never a good thing, right? There is never, I don't know. Even if you're in an active audit, a better response would be, I don't have that information at this time. But I can follow up in an email, in a phone call, and provide that later, right? Just put your own flavor to it. Never, I don't know. You never want to say, I don't know. I've heard some things that you would think is unprofessional and you would think that nobody would say in the audit, but it has happened. So don't be that guy. Know your stuff. The second important item is understand the auditing process. So basically, know who's coming, know what they're looking for, understand the type of audit you're going to be going under. There are different types of audits. There are documentation audits where everybody sits at a desk, conference meeting, and they go over policy, go over documentation. There are demonstrations where they want you to show them something on a server, log into something, check some settings, check some reg keys, whatever the case have you. There's those type of audits. There are different type of audits. Know which audit you are going to be falling under. There are hybrids where it is both policy, demonstration, physical space inspection. There's all types, right? So that also helps you understand what's going on, right? Never go in blind, right? Don't just show up without understanding what type of audit is going to be. Generally for scheduled auditing events, there's some time given. There may be a schedule provided, right? You know where you are, where you land in the schedule. Understand what's going on. Understand the time frame and understand what type of audit is going to be. If you understand that, you'll be better prepared along with step one, or the first tip, which was know your stuff, right? For policy, for policy audits, generally they're going over documentation. They want to make sure your organization has all their policies documented in writing. So what would that entail? making sure you have all your policies. They're all signed. They're all relatively recent. No, you know, documentation really, really old, you know, 3, 4, 5 year plus old, right? Generally, you want to have annual reviews where you're updating documents, changes, policies, and all that stuff, right? So those are pretty relatively easy if you have good documentation skills. If it's a demonstration, they may have a team come in. They may sit with you at the servers. They want you to log into things. They want you to log into machines. They want to check registry keys. They want to see your policies. They want to see security policies or whatever. Make sure you understand what type of audit it is and prepare for it, right? Physical inspections, they're going to see your space. They may want to look at a secure operations center, look into your SOC, look into your NOC, check for physical security processes. And if it is one of these, make sure you follow your process, right? Don't walk them into a building. Don't walk them into a space without checking IDs, checking, you know, clearances, all that stuff. This is all basic stuff. You never want to, don't take shortcuts with an audit. If there's one thing you're going to do, you're not going to do, is take shortcuts of your process and policies during an actual audit, because for all intents and purposes, you're being graded on your process in real time at the same time. You know what I'm saying? So keep that in mind. Know what type of audit it's going to be. Another good tip, third tip, is to perform regular assessments on yourself, right? Get your team, get your management, have mock audits. You know, have somebody pretend to be an auditor and then have them question or go through a checklist to, you know, somebody on the team. You know what I'm saying? A good way to get comfortable is to do the mock audits for yourself, and take it seriously, right? Act as if it's a real audit. You can get better practice that way, and also check yourself, right? This is part of continuous monitoring, you know, implementing your own steps, actually doing the work you're supposed to be doing in the organization or anyway, right? But if you're doing a mock audit for yourself, you know, regular assessments, you can understand where you see fit. And also you may be able to discover who may be best to speak on what thing, right? You know, like if you have a large team, you can find out who's best at what, who's best at speaking, who's best at answering questions, who may be more knowledgeable in certain things. So it helps you iron out and find your key players. Regular assessments for yourself. This could be monthly. This could be quarterly. I think anything less frequent than quarterly might be, especially for DoD, might be too infrequent. So maybe anything more than quarterly would be best. The requirements, the checklists, the security regulations are out there on the portals, on the DoD websites, on what's that website? I forget it. I'm going to put it here. Check yourself, right? Run the STIGs. Run the scans. Everything is provided. It's very rare for an auditor to ask for something that should not be already understood to be occurring, or a process that should be occurring, right? I've rarely seen it. You know, obviously, DoD does update regulations, but it's very rare, right? For the most part, everything is put out there and then some, right? So always be prepared. Do regular assessments for yourself, test your staff, test yourself, do mock audits. And I would especially do a mock audit before an actual audit, right? So you can get comfortable, maybe get butterflies out, get jitters out. I think that's a no-brainer, right? I feel like regular assessments should be a part of just the process of cybersecurity in a military environment anyway. So, all right, and the fourth step, this is not even, I don't even feel like this is a step. This is just something that should be done along with regular assessments, is just your continuous monitoring, right? Every organization, agency should have a continuous monitoring program, especially if you're DoD, military, federal agency, right? This actually is, what's the word I'm looking for? Mandated from the DoD. So you should have a continuous monitoring program. Continuous monitoring is basically monitoring the security status of your application, system, network. Make sure you have a secure operations center. You have people that are watching the system for attacks, for breaches. You know, this should be basic cybersecurity knowledge or basic practices, right? You can't have a system up and nobody's actively watching it to make sure it doesn't go down, it doesn't get hacked, it doesn't get attacked, you know, it's not acting funky. You know, there should be a continuous monitoring, because I can guarantee you, in an audit, there's going to be questions on your continuous monitoring program. Have those people there, your incident response, have them there, obviously. They may or may not ask you about past incidents, and they may ask, how did you rectify? How did you clear it? How did you close it out? How did you fix it? You know, the steps you took. So have those people in attendance. Again, that's one of these things that should be understood, should be known in a security program, but you'd be surprised, right? Your continuous monitoring program is supposed to help you, would help you in that instance during an audit, and also help you and your organization as a whole. And this last one is also a no-brainer. Should be relatively easy to understand. Prepare your documentation, prepare your policies, right? I guess unless it's not a policy audit, but generally there's going to be policy documentation questions. Make sure you have all your policies ready to go. Have them signed. Have them updated. Have them printed out. Have them available on a share. Have them in digital format or wherever you keep them. Because at any time, again, during an audit, they can ask, hey, where is this policy? Show it to us. You can show them printed. You can show them on a share. Have it available. Last thing you want to do, and I've seen it plenty of times, ask for a policy and you're shuffling papers. You're trying to find it. You know it's on a share. You feel like it's on his website. You know you've seen it somewhere before. You know, prepare. Have it all in one place. You know what I'm saying? Have it all in one share drive if you want to have it electronically saved. Print them all out. Have them on the desk. Put them in binders. Make it neat. Make it look nice. You know what I mean? So this sets auditors at ease. I know because I've been there. I've audited organizations where they had a conference table full of binders. And I've audited organizations where you ask for a policy and they give you something from 10 years ago, signed by somebody who's not there anymore. I've seen it. I've seen it all. So update your policies, update your documentation, make sure it's relatively new. Make sure the people responsible for signing it are still there. So basically the program manager, whoever, person of interest that is present there at the moment of the audit has a fresh copy signed by that person, by the individual. Generally, that's a good, that's a good best practice. You don't want to have a policy signed by the previous person. You know, I've seen it happen. I've seen it happen with the person that was there five persons ago. You know, like this was signed by somebody who's not alive anymore. You know, I've seen it happen. So with those five tips, you should be good to go. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. Also, check out the website, cyberbunee.com. Please like, share, and subscribe. Follow this page, and I will see you soon. Thank you so much.